Going on, guys? I am back again with another top string tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to string up a Huron top string. So a Huron's a take on a spin-off of an Iroquois style top string. Again, as you may have seen in my post last week, using a drop top string, so we're lowering the release point of our stick down, which makes for a faster release, but still allows for a deeper pocket. So I've got a pretty decent low to mid pocket that I like to play with in this stick. But a quick release point thanks to the top string. So if you're interested in finding out more about these types of top strings, you can check out the post that I put up. But let's go ahead and get started. So with the Huron top string, it's kind of nice if you're into a custom pocket because you use three different strings and you can kind of pick and choose your colors, add a little flair to the stick. I picked up this Reebok 9K in Woozles colors. Gotta rock the Woozles. For like $23 on lacrosse.com. So I'm going to stick with the Woozles theme and start with a pink rail. And the rail is what sort of sets apart the Huron top string from the Iroquois top string. So this is going to be your shortest top string. You really just need enough to get a bit further than the distance of the head, the width of the head. And to start, you're just going to take your rail through the sidewall and in through the front of the stick. And again, I like to string looking at the back of my stick, so that might help you. And then another thing to point out is that with the Huron, you're going to want to use a 10 diamond top string, or a 10 diamond row of mesh across the top. And we're going to actually use each piece of, or each mesh hole. So it's really important that you have 10, otherwise you'll get all the way over and not have a symmetrical Huron top string. So I go in through the front, I'm going to come back around the back side of the sidewall, put my rail through, and cinch that down nice and tight to the top. And it's really important that you keep this rail fairly tight. And this is where it gets kind of complicated. So the rail is going to run under the fold of the mesh, across. I'm tucking my mesh back over so the rail is underneath to that last, that 10th diamond. I'm going to go into the mesh and out the sidewall from the inside to the outside, keeping the rail underneath that fold. And then I'm going to wrap back around through that 10th diamond and out through that same sidewall hole that I just used. I'll show you here in just a second, to cinch it down across the top. So you can see I've cinched it down, and right now the rail isn't touching the mesh, but you'll fix that as you tie in your other strings. And I like to start with this almost as tight as I can get it. Once you've strung up your top string, you'll want to adjust the rail to get it to the tension that you're hoping to have. If you have it really tight, you're going to get some twang off of it as the ball is releasing. And if you have it too loose, you may end up hitting plastic if the rest of your top string's not tight enough. So this is something that you really just have to kind of play around with and adjust to your liking. I like to tighten it as tight as I can when I'm stringing up the head. And then that gives me more play in the end. And it also makes it easier for me to string up the second and third top strings. So I'm going to go with a white top string for my first top string, my first part of the Huron string. And I use about an arm's length of top string. If you have one of the kits that the String It Forward packs came with from Gymalax, the top string is the perfect length, so I didn't have to cut it, didn't have to mess with it at all. And basically, I'm going to go in through the same sidewall hole that I started with. And I'm coming, pull that string through, and I'm going to go in the mesh underneath the rail that I just strung up. And then back through the loop that I created with the top string hole. So I'll show you a close up here, but you're coming in through the sidewall, around the front of the mesh, and then back through the loop itself. And you're gonna skip your first diamond. I take that back. You're gonna use your first diamond on the top of your string. And you're going through the back of the head and underneath the loop that you've created. So there you can see. And then through the back again. And in through the loop for a second time, and you're creating a nice and tight top string knot. You're gonna now take that and skip a diamond, go through the back of the mesh, and in through the loop that you just created. In the back of the mesh again, and in through the loop that you created one more time. I'll show you a better shot here in just a second. So basically, you're just doing the opposite of the top of the stick. And we're going to skip a top string opening, go through the back of the stick, out the front, and into that loop. Do that twice. So through the back, through that big loop that you just created. So you can see making my loop coming through and pull it nice and tight. Then I'm skipping a diamond again, and I'm going through the back of my mesh. And underneath. Then I'm going to wrap around through the front of the mesh. And through that loop that I just created. And you can see it's really important that when you're going through your mesh holes, that you're going around the rail that you installed initially. So that pink string that I used, I'm hooking it with the knots that I'm tying. I'm gonna skip again up top through that loop that I created. So there's a good look at how I'm crossing up. Back through the back again. And through that loop. A second time, skip through the back, coming underneath the string, wrap around to the front, making that knot. And you want to really try and make sure that your triangles are symmetrical, so you want both sides of this string to be about the same length. And you do that through making sure that everything is nice and tight. Back through the back. Around. Through the front. through that loop again. Again, making it nice and tight. Pearl shear to help. Skip a diamond through the back, through the loop, through the front. Up to the top. And as with all of these tutorials, this is just one way to do it. There is no right or wrong unless you're totally messing up. So if you have a different take on it, we'd love to see that too. So now that I've gone all the way across, you can see that there's one diamond left, but I've done five. So instead of going through the mesh again, I'm actually just going out the sidewall hole and tying it nice and tight. And like the rail, this is something you may have to adjust. I often use needle nose pliers to tighten up my strings when I'm all done with them. And then the last string that I'm going to use is a black top string, same thing, about an arm's length from my chest to my hand to go across. And I'm just doing the exact same thing but backwards. So last time I started for me on the left side of the stick for the screen to be the right. This time I'm starting on the right side or on the screen it'd be the left. I'm going in through the front. And back up through the loop. And now I'm going to be in the second top string hole through the back. Out the front. And this is kind of your choice. I like to go behind on one side and in front on another side with my second string. You can do it all behind, you can do it all in front, and I'll show you what I mean there in just a second. Going down through the back, nice and tight. And you'll notice as you're doing up your second string that it's gonna really pull that rail closer to the top, and you'll get a little bit more slack in your first string. So you're really gonna wanna, like I said, use those pliers to pull out the slack. And this is what I meant by over and under. So you can see going up crosses in front of the white, going down comes behind the back of the white string. And basically I'm just going to repeat that pattern throughout the rest of the stick. Some people do their top knots a little bit differently than I do. They'll reverse it. So instead of going back through the back twice, they will come through the front on the second way around. If you like the way that that looks a bit better, that's a good spin that you can take on this. I kind of like the feeling that I get with the stick strung this way. I think that it helps because of the diamonds being off. You do every other diamond with one color and every other diamond with another color. I think by doing out the back twice, it really helps pull the mesh evenly to both sides. But really, it's just repeating that pattern across the side, and that's it. There's not much to it. So there you have it, guys. This is my take on the Huron top string. You can play with the knots a little bit, tighten them up around the diamonds. As I said, you can go in and adjust the tightness of the rail. You can see mine's pretty tight right now, so I might get a little extra twang when the ball's rolling out of the pocket. I hope this helps, and check back next week for my take on the Iroquois top string. Thanks.